Heavenly Father, good morning. From the rising of the sun until it's going down, let your name be praised.
亲爱的天父, 早上好, 从日出之地到日落之处, 耶和华的名是应当赞美的。
Your sons and daughters in eternity are gathered here in your place.
你们在永恒之中的儿女们今天在你的殿中聚集在这里。
Open our mouths, O Lord. May our song rise to you and make you smile.
主啊, 祈求你能够开我们的口, 使我们的歌声能够, 达到你的面前。
Open our ears, O Lord. May we hear the word of wisdom from the scripture.
主啊, 开我们的耳, 使我们的耳朵能够听见从这些经文当中来自于你那的智慧。
Open our eyes, O Lord. May we see your glory and truth.
主啊, 也祈求你开我们的眼睛。 使我们能够看到你的荣耀和真理。
Most importantly, Lord, open our hearts so we can love you as you love us.
主啊, 更重要的是, 祈求你能够打开我们的心, 使我们能够像你那样,爱我们一样, 我们爱你。
In the precious name of Jesus, we pray.
我们奉耶稣基督宝贵的名, 祷告, Amen.
Amen. Brothers and sisters, we come to the final chapter of my series of sermon regarding prayer.
弟兄姐妹们,今天我们来到我开始讲的一系列的题目,就是关于祷告的题目,是最后的一堂课了。This
is prayer part 7.
应该今天是第七讲。Of
course, there is more, much more to say about prayer, but I consider that it is time to conclude what we have discussed.
当然关于祷告这个主题呢,我们还有很多很多的可以讲,但是呢,我想呢,这是时候我们要做一个结论的时候。We
have faced the most difficult question, what is prayer?
我们很多少人都面对一个比较困难的问题,就是说什么才是祷告呢?
I have mentioned all Hallisby's definition.
我提到过关于哈里斯比关于祷告的这个定义。
To pray is nothing more involved than to open the door, giving Jesus access to our need and permitting him to exercise his own power in dealing with them.
祷告不是别的,只是它是打开心门。 给耶稣呢开条门路，让他来帮助我们，让他运用自己的能力解决我们的难题。That
simply means to pray is to let Jesus be the Lord.
简单的来说呢，这个定义呢，就是说让耶稣基督做我们个人的主。I
also mentioned Gary Miller's definition.
我也提到过关于 Gary 李勒。
Prayer is a call to God to fulfill his promise.
祷告就是呼求神实现他的应许。
And we did a Bible study on that, remember?
大家记得吗? 我们关于这个定义我们还做过一次查经的学习。
I also gave my own definition of prayer.
我也给出了关于我从我自己的感悟上来对于祷告的定义。
Prayer is the pleading from my real self to the real God.
我的定义关于祷告就是以真实的我的自己来到真实的神的面前。
And I also show you the picture that I took from my daughter's classroom.
我也给大家展示了一幅一个照片,是从我女儿的学校教室里我拍的一张照片。
It says, prayer begins by talking to God, but it ends by listening to him.
那个照片上写着就是祷告呢, 就是开始是向神说话, 结束呢，就是要倾听神的声音。
I believe that we all have our own definition of what is prayer.
我相信我们说关于祷告的定义，我们都接触了好几种。
These definitions are developed from the experience and the feeling of ourselves as human beings. And we can even use the scripture to verify these experience and feelings.
当然这些定义，对祷告的定义呢，是从我们作为一个人一些对这个一些经历和一些感受当中逐渐的演变和发展而出来的。但是这当然我们也可以从经文当中来证实这我们这样的一种经历和感受。
The question is, why are many Christians still not regularly praying every day?
但是下一个问题就是为什么这么多基督徒他不是每一天都要去祷告呢?
Now I think all of us know the simple answer.
现在我认为你们都会知道这个简单的答案是什么。
Because it seems prayer cannot change God. That's why so many Christians lost their interest in prayer.
因为似乎是这样，因为你祷告不能够改变神，所以这就是为什么很多的基督徒很快的他们就对祷告失去了兴趣。
But prayer can surely change things, and more importantly, prayer can surely change us. Right?
但祷告的确是可以改变一件事情的，并且祷告的确也是可以改变我们的，对不对？
But do we want it? Do we long for the change?
但是问题就在于我们想不想这样，但是我们渴不渴望要来改变我们自己。
And one more question, do we love him?
那更深一步的一个问题就来了，就是我们爱主吗？
And then next, when we talk about why we pray, I gave two reasons.
当我们谈到为什么我们要祷告的时候，我给出了两个原因。
By praying, we can find God in all things based on two of God's attributes, the transcendence of God and the immanence of God.
但是基于这个神的两个比较重要的特质呢，就是神的超越和神的内住这两个特性呢，所以呢，我们就发现祷告，我们可以在一切的东西当中找到神。
And the second, we are living souls. Souls have desires.
第二点呢，我们是活着的灵魂，所以活着的灵魂呢，它都有渴望的东西。
And prayer is a heart-to-heart communication to express the desire to the living God.
祷告就是一种由从心到心与表达一种跟一这样活生生的一个神这样一种交流和交通。
So living soul expression living God, because we are alive, that's why we pray.
所以呢，我们这个活着的灵魂，我们情感的表达，然后这位活生生的神，所以因为我们是活着的，我们是活生生的，所以那就是为什么我们要祷告。
We all know God in our heads.But only through the calling of his name, through the desire to get an answer, and through heart-to-heart communication, then we will know God, or I should say, experience God in our hearts.
我们在我们的脑海里面都知道有个神，但是只有通过我们呼求神的名字，通过在这种表达，通过我们以一种渴望要得到从神那里来的答案的回答。并且我们和神之间有一个从心到心的交通和交流，我们才会这样真正的认识神，或者我应该说呢，在我们的心里面呢，我们要经历神的同在。
In reality, God is the one who initiates our prayers. He is the one who leads our prayers, and He is the one who answers our prayer.
但实际上呢，神就是那样呢，激发我们。引导我们开始祷告的那位，他也是那位呢引导我们怎样祷告的那位，同时呢，他也是回应我们祷告的那位。
As we venture deeper into the question why we pray, we wonder if God already knows everything we're going to say why we pray.
如果我们要再深挖这个问题的话，为什么我们要祷告呢？我们都会想知道，如果神他已经知道一切的事情了，我们要说什么，要做什么，他都知道，为什么我们还要祷告呢？
Because in the beginning, in the Garden of Eden, God is there, present with man and woman. They have intimate relationship. They have uninterrupted communication.
因为起初的时候，在伊甸园，神在那里，他就与那个男人和那个女人同在一起，他们之间的关系也是非常的亲密的，并且呢，他们的交流也是没有障碍的。所以呢，但是
，But sin occurred, woman and man were driven out. The presence of God was lost. The relationship was broken. The communication was stopped.
但是当罪出现的时候呢，这个男人和那个女人就被逐出了园子，所以呢，这种关系，神的同在的这种关系没有了，这种良好的关系呢，已经破裂了，然后他们的交流，他们的交通也就没有了。
Now, the Father, who numbered the very hairs of our heads,He knows thoughts in our minds, and he knows what we are going to need before we know it. But still, he says, come and tell me what you need.
好，到了现在，我们的天父，他甚至数算过我们头上的头发的根数，他就需要我们要来认识他，甚至我们在知道之前，他知道我们需要什么。我们要说什么?
Brothers and sisters, when he does that, that is not for his benefit.
弟兄姐妹们，当神这样做的时候，神并不是为了他自己的益处。
When he asks us to come and tell him what our concern is, what our concerns are and our needs, he is inviting us into the sacred presence of the Almighty. He is inviting us back to the Garden of Eden.
当神要求我们来到他的面前，要告诉他我们关心的是什么，我们需要的是什么，他实际上是邀请我们与这位全能的神，他的神圣的同在，他并且呢，就是好像是要求我们回到伊甸园那种场景。
In prayer, relationship, relationship back online, and communication back online.
在祷告中，我们这种跟神的关系建立起来了，这种交通交流也建立起来。
So from there, we understand deeper about why we pray.
所以从这里呢，我们就更深一个层面，能够明白和理解为什么我们要祷告。
We also talk about here and there on the hours of prayer, the posture, attitude of prayer, the content, belief, efficacy, etc. of prayer.
我们也零零星星的谈到了一些关于祷告的时辰啊。祷告的知识啊，祷告的态度啊，或者我们祷告的内容，我们的信仰，或者我们祷告的效率等等等等。
We discuss what to pray because we try to avoid praying those prayerless prayers.
所以我们也讨论了关于要祷告什么祷告的内容，我们祷告什么，因为我们想避免那种无谓的祷告。
I also gave an example to demonstrate that if a hypocrite prays a beautiful prayer in front of people, what will that prayer accomplish?
我当时也给大家举了一个例子，就是一个假冒伪善的人，他在人的面前很用很漂亮的话语来怎么祷告，就他这样的祷告最终完成的是什么呢？
The people may admire the hypocrite, butGod will not want anything to do with the person and the prayer.
这就对在他面前的这些人呢，也许他们会、哦、你祷告的话语很漂亮，很真，好像感到很尊敬他，但是对于神来讲，对于这个人和他的祷告，神是完全不在乎。
Prayer is not about politely and elegantly organizing words to say to God.
祷告呢，并不是 表示我们用什么样的漂亮的话语，或者用什么什么的优雅组织的文句来到神的面前向他祷告。
God searches human hearts.
但是神是寻求我们人的内心。
In true prayers, you know who you are calling, and the one you are calling knows who you are. It is a two-way communication with clear identity confirmation.
在真正的祷告当中呢，你祷告的时候，你知道你呼求的是谁？那位呼求的人呢，他也知道是谁在呼求他。这是一种双向的一种交流，并且双方都知道对方，明确的知道对方的身份。
Prayer is done in front of God. So prayer is not about appearance, it's about the essence.
所以祷告呢是在神的面前来做出来的。所以 祷告呢不是关乎到你的礼仪啊，这些繁文缛节啊，而是关乎到你的内心。
After clearing out all the important concept of prayer, we start to focus on the practical part of prayer.
所以当我们清除掉这些所有的关于祷告的这些概念上的理解的这些问题过后，下一步就我们就要开始要实践我们来怎样的祷告。
So we explore the question how to pray.
所以我们就进一步来探索这个怎样祷告。
We study the structure of the Lord's Prayer.
我们当时呢也调研或者研究了主导文的结构。
The opening calls out to God.
在主导文的开始呢，就是向神呼求。
In the first half, the heart goes up for God's name, God's kingdom, and God's will.
所以在第一部分呢，就是因着神的名字、神的国和神的旨意，我们的心呢上腾。
And the second half, the heart settles down for our needs, our debts, and our danger.
所以第二部分呢，就是对于我们的这个需要、我们的债和我们的处于的危险的状态。
And then,
我们的时候心往下沉。
And then the ending, praising God.
所以在最后呢，那我们就是赞美神。
The first half is centered on God and His kingdom. Love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind.
所以第一部分呢，就是把神和神的国是放在 C 位的中心的位置。所以你要尽心、尽性、尽意爱主你的神。
The second half is still centered on God.Because we pray for our needs, but we don't pray centered on ourselves.
在第二部分呢，也是把神放在中间的位置，因为我们是为我们的需求而祷告，我们并不是为了祷告我们要成为处于中心聚焦的位置。
Love thy neighbor as thyself is a satisfaction to God's heart.
所以神当我听看到我们爱邻舍如同自己。他心得满足。
So in our prayers, we first call God to bring His heavenly kingdom down.
所以在我们的祷告中，我们开始的呼求，神把他的天国降下来。
Purify His people and glorify Himself and to exalt His Son, Jesus Christ.
洁净他的子民，然后荣耀他自己，并且高举他的儿子，耶稣基督。
And we will seek His will, and we will acknowledge His will, and we will carry out His will in our lives.
我们寻求他的旨意，并且呢，我们也承认他的旨意在我们的生命当中，并把他的旨意彰显出来。
Then we pray for ourselves, pray for our needs, and make intercessions for the people that we care about.
然后我们为我们自己祷告。 为我们的需求，为我们的需要所祷告，为我们所关心的人来代求。
We long to see God's providence, God's forgiveness, and God's protection on us and the people that we care for.
我们就寻求神的供应，神的赦免，并且神对我们的保护。
So I also introduce the four-part practice of prayer, ACTS.
So 我也介绍了一个祷告的一个四部分的一种实践，也就是 ACTS, ACTS.
Have you guys practiced it at your own time?
所以你们在家里面自己做功课，自己这样来祷告了吗？
Today we will introduce more ways to pray.
所以今天我们还要介绍有更多的方法来祷告。
There was a person named Peter.
有一个人叫彼得。
He had a barber shop in a small town of Wittenberg.
有一个在温德堡的地方呢，他那个小镇上面他有一个理发店。
If you know this place, the great reformer Martin Luther was one of his customers.
如果你知道这个温丁堡这个地方呢，最伟大的宗教改革家马丁路德呢，他就是这个理发店的一个常客顾客。
So Peter knew Luther's reputation, not only he being a brilliant theologian and courage reformer, but of being a well-known warrior of prayer, giving himself to pray every day for 2 to 3 hours.
所以这个理发师彼得呢，他知道马丁路德是他的名义，他不知道他是一个，他知道他是一个宗教改革家，一个虔诚的一个祷告的斗士，他每天呢要祷告2到3个小时。
So one day when Luther came, Peter asked, Dr. Luther, could you please teach me how to pray?
有一天当这个马丁路德来到他理发店理发的时候，这理发师就问他路德博士，你能够教我怎样祷告吗？
We remember the same questions that the disciples asked Jesus when they noticed the obvious connection between Jesus' life and Jesus' prayer.
大家记得耶稣的门徒，让他知道他们明白耶稣的这个祷告和耶稣的生命之间有这样紧密的联系过后呢，他向耶稣也提出了同样的问题，问主我们怎样祷告。
And Luther said to Master Peter, the barber of Wittenberg, certainly,I will teach you something of this matter.
当然这个马丁路德呢就告诉这位理发师傅就是说，当然我会教你怎样祷告。
After his shave and his haircut, Luther went back to his study. He picked up his pen and he wrote a small booklet simply for his barber.
当马丁路德他刮完了脸理完了发，他就回到那个座位上，他都来学习的时候，他都拿起一支笔，拿一个小本子，都写下了为这个位理发师写下了怎样简单祷告的一个小册子。
And he titled it "A Simple Way to Pray."
这本小册子的名字呢，就简易祷告法。
Now this little book, "A Simple Way to Pray," is known to the world.And we can all read it.
但当今呢，当然这本小册子就变成了一个世界上最著名的祷告的小册子，我们所有的人都可以去读这个小册子。
And in that book, Luther indicated to his barber, to be benefit from the book, first, we must take the time and discipline to memorize Ten Commandments, the Lord's Prayer, and the Apostles' Creed.
当然路德呢在这本小册子怎样祷告 简易祷告法这本小册子里向他的理发师说明了，如果你要从这小祷告的小册子受益的话呢，你必须要记住 要 背, 背诵这个十诫，然后呢还有主导文，还有这些使徒当时他们的关于教义方面的这些原则问题。
And 100 years later, Madam Jane Goen wrote a book called The Short and Easy Method of Prayer.
当然在100年之后呢，叫盖恩夫人呢 也写了一本书叫简易祷告法。
If you look at the Chinese, you can tell the Chinese name of two books are the same.
如果你看中文翻译的话，这两本小册子都是一样的名字。
They are all for encouraging us to pray, even make it easy for us to pray.
这两本书都是鼓励我们，激励我们去祷告，并且呢，甚至使我们的祷告变得更容易。
Many other people teach simple ways to pray because prayer is supposed to be simple.
当然，许多其他的人呢，也在教导怎样来简单的来祷告，因为祷告本身，假如祷告不是很简单的。
Now I'm going to introduce some simple ways to pray.
所以我现在呢，介绍给大家一些比较简单的祷告的方法。
But before I introduce them, let me be clear. Our spiritual ancestor leave us these treasures regarding prayer. The goal of these ways of prayer is not to give us information. Instead, they teach us about living wisely.
在介绍这些简单方法之前，我要给大家上面一点的是呢，这些我们在属灵上面的先辈们给我们留下这些财富，关于祷告，他的目的呢？他们祷告的目的，他并不是给我们只是一些信息方面的一些东西，而是要教导我们怎样有理性的、明智的、有智慧的活着。
To learn it, it takes obedience, submission of will, change of heart, and a tender, teachable spirit.
所以这都需要我们呢。要有这个顺服的心，一个顺服神的旨意的心，一个我们可以改变我们自己心肠的心，还有一个温柔可以教导，可以教导的灵。
Okay, simple ways to pray. The first simple way to pray is breathing.
所以第一个简单的祷告就是吸气。
You breathe.You pray. Isn't that simple?
非常简单。你吸气，你就祷告。
I teach these in our Chinese daily devotion.
在我们中文的成人的灵修的每天的灵修里面，我会用这种方法来教导他们祷告。
This is how you do it. When we breathe in, inhale slowly.Recall all the instances of the presence, the comfort, the blessing of the Lord since we were reborn. And breathe them slowly into your body, into your life, just like receiving a gift from God's hand.
好，家里面这怎么祷告？简单祷告，就吸气。当你吸的时候，慢慢的吸，就想一想你自己从得救重生过后发生在自己身上的每一件事，神的同在，神的安慰，以及神对你的祝福的话，这样慢慢的吸到你的身体里面，然后呢，到你的生命里面，好像每一件事呢，就是从上帝的手上呢，接过一个礼物一样，慢慢的。
And when you breathe out, exhale slowly. We commit our cares.And burdens our sorrow and regrets one by one into the hands of God. He cleanses, He forgives, He heals.
当我们一个是吸气，一个是呼气出来，呼出去的时候呢，也要慢慢的呼出，然后把我们身上的一些担子、一些负担，我们自己的病痛、也痛苦，为我们当中后悔的事情，一件一件的就把它卸给神的手里面，所以呢，他神就会接近我们，他也会赦免我们，并且可能医治，也可以医治我们。
breathe in, breathe out. When you breathe, you remember those Bible verses. For example, breathe in, you remember, you can have Matthew chapter 4, verse 4 in your head.
所以当然在吸气、呼气这个事情上，我们记得，在马太福音里面也讲过第四章第四节。
然后and then when you exhale, you can, for example, remember 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 7.
当你呼出气的时候，你可能会想起在彼得前书的第五章第七节讲到。
So just breathe in, breathe out.And then you are praying.
一个是吸气，一个出气，你就祷告了。
The second simple way to pray is to read.
第二个简单的方法祷告呢，就是读。
Read the book of Psalms.
特别是要读诗篇。
Simple.
简单吧。
Charles Spurgeon, commenting on the Psalms, said, "These sacred hymns expressed."All modes of human feeling. They are fit both for the childhood and the old age. They furnished maxims for the entrance of life and serve as a watchword at the gate of death. The battle of life, the repose of Sabbath, the war of the hospital.The guest chamber of the mansion, the church, the oratory. Yes, even heaven itself may be entered with psalms.
所以查尔斯·斯布珍呢，对这个诗篇做了这样如下的一些评论：这些神圣的诗篇表达了一切形式的人类情感，既适用于儿童，也适用于老年人。他们成为人生的开端的格言。成为死亡之门前的口令，表达生命之奋斗，成就安息日的休整。他们是医院的病房，豪宅的客房，教堂的讲章。是的，甚至天堂也应该带着这些诗篇进入。
Such a beautiful comment.
所以斯布珍对诗篇的这样的评论真的是太美妙了。
Another one, John Calvin. He calls the Psalms an anatomy. of all parts of the soul. For there's not an emotion of which anyone can be conscious that is not there, represented as in a mirror.
所以对另一篇呢，就是从约翰·加尔文，他对诗篇是这样讲的，对灵魂各个部分做出剖析，因为每个人能意识到的情感都在这里，在诗篇里面，如同面对镜子一样，都可以找到。
Simply just read the book of Psalms out loud and echo it with our heart, and that can be our prayer.
所以简单的说呢，就是大声的，诵读、朗读诗篇，然后在我们的心里面呢，把它回想出来，这就是我们的祷告。
The third simple way of prayer is to sing.
第三个最简单的方法呢，祷告的简单方法就是歌唱。
I should demonstrate this one, but we don't have enough time. This way, singing is related to the second one.
本来我要给大家表演一段的，但没时间了。这是现在第三种方法跟第二种方法是紧密相关的。
It's related to reading the book of Psalms. We should pick hymns.That were written or inspired by the text of the Psalms from the scripture and then sing them.
所以呢，关于歌唱，我们要去选一些圣诗呢。这些圣诗的，歌词呢，是基于诗篇的一些经文这样来传送下来的。所以通过这样来唱这些圣诗呢，我们也是祷告。
This morning when you sing that.Song, it is well with my soul. After you sing four verses, you are like reading or hearing a sermon already, right?
像今天早上我们领会的唱第三首敬拜诗的时候呢，你如果要跟着唱这四段下来，你就好像就你听了一篇讲道一样。
But I guess in the modern days, we may have one more option. That is, we can pick the praising songs that once we sing, it will just stuck in our heads, circling there. And then that will be our prayer.
所以当然在现代的日子里，如果我们选了一首歌，我们唱这首歌，这种歌词呢，都会印记在我们的脑海里面。
The fourth simple way to pray is silence.
第四个简单的方法的祷告呢，就是静默。
It is difficult to find silence in the age of technology and information.
当然在现在技术很发达并且信息爆炸的时代，我们真的是很难 聚焦在这种静默的这个祷告的方式。
Silence asks for patience and waiting, but both silence and waiting makes us uncomfortable.
所以静默祷告都需要我们要有耐心，要能够等待的心。这两者就是一个是耐心和等待的心呢，就是使我们感到不舒服。
Because they are unproductive.
因为一点效率都没有。
It challenges our culture addiction to amusement, words, music, advertising, noise, alarm, and voices.
因为这是对我们传统的文化的一个挑战，因为我们喜好的就是找乐子啊，带了乐子，很好的音乐啦，很漂亮的话语啊，或者极限音乐，很大的噪音啊，这是我们喜欢这些东西。
To get through the flood of words, we develop skills like skimming and scanning.
所以要因为我们被这些所有的这些话语啊这些东西所像洪水一样淹没了我们就发展出了一种技巧，就是所谓的把上面的泡沫给抹去，或者叫扫描。
We look for bullet points and bold prints. We ask for summary.
所以我们当我们看这个东西，我们老往是就看见那些打了重点标记的那些重要的点，或者呢一些摘要的东西。
The trouble is there are so many other things stuck in our minds that the sermon evaporated by the time we reach the parking lot.
这问题就在于这个我们太多的东西在我们的脑海里面蹦出来了，甚至在这个我们讲到这些内容在我们走回到停车场之前可能就已经忘掉了，蒸发掉了。
Silent prayer invites us to leave behind the noisy world for the time alone with Jesus.
所以静默祷告呢，需要我们要跟耶稣基督呢，就是单独的静静的相处。
Silence offers a way of paying attention to the Spirit of God.
所以静默呢也提供一种方式，使我们跟这位神的灵呢有一个注意点。
In quietness, we often notice things we would rather not notice or feel. Pockets of sadness or anger.Or loneliness or impatience begin to surface.
当我们安静下来的时候，我们经常会注意到一些事情，我们在平时或者比较烦躁的时候呢，意识不到或者感觉不到东西，并且我们自己身上的一些情感，比如说忧伤啦，愤怒啦，或者孤单啦，或者就是说不耐烦啦，没有耐心的这些都会。爆发出来。
In silence, we often struggle with the feeling that we are wasting time.
当然，在静默祷告的时候，我们往往自我一个意识就是说我好像这样是浪费时间。
Everything we notice in this struggle can become an invitation of prayer.
所以每一件事情在这种我们这种挣扎当中呢，就变成了是我们一种想乐于想祷告。
It's like a can opener. The silence open up the contents of our heart.
就像我们的开罐器一样，一开的时候呢，这种静默呢，就把我们内心的一些东西给打开了。
allowing us deeper access to God than we experience at other times.
这个时候呢，是我们跟神呢有更进一步的亲近和了解，比平时更多。
Be alone with God. Offer your mind and your body in and our attention to God as a prayer.
所以与神有一个独处的一个时间段，所以在敬拜祷告这段时间呢，你可以把你的这种献给神。
In silence, there's nothing we need to do here.
所以就说在这里静默祷告没有什么可以做的。
There's not a time to come up with strategies for fixing our lives.
这也不是我们要修理或者调整我们生活当中遇到的问题的时候。
Silence is a time to rest in God.Lean into God, trusting and being with Him in silence will loosen our rootedness in this world and plant us by the streams of the living water.
静默祷告呢，就是我们在神里面安得安息，并且呢，要依靠靠在神的身上，要相信他。他会把我们从这种烦躁的世界当中把这个根给我们拔出来，并且呢把我们种植在这个溪流的草地上。
Okay, there's many more simple ways to pray. We don't have time to go through them one by one. Let me offer you the last one.
所以有很多很多的简单的祷告方法，我们不能在这里再一一的奥数了，所以我在最后一个跟你讲一个最后的一个祷告。
The last one, join our prayer meeting.
所以加入我们的祷告会。
This is obviously a simple way to pray because if you join, you will be forced to pray. Isn't that simple?
这简单，肯定祷告会也是一个非常简单的祷告，因为你一加入到祷告会，你就被推着让你要祷告。
Now, prayer, in the early 16th century in Spain, there is a sister called Teresa of Avila.
在早16世纪的早期，在西班牙有一位姊妹呢，叫阿维拉的特蕾莎。
Not Mother Teresa, it's very, very old, 16th century,
early. 这不是特蕾莎妈妈啊，母亲，而是在比那早，就是十六世纪的早期，在阿拉维的特蕾莎。
She was well known for her prayer life.
因为她以她自己有一个祷告的生命呢而著称。
One of her famous prayer was at the time when she was fighting the flu.
有一个最著名的祷告呢，就是当她得了流感的时候。
Let's say she got COVID.
也就是说今天我们的新冠病毒。
She got COVID, and then in her prayer, she was, she complained to the Lord that she has a sore throat and a high temperature, and this prevent her from serving in the church.
在她的祷告中，她就向神抱怨了她的嗓子喉咙疼。并且发烧，所以这样呢，他就是身体的不养了，就是阻止了他服侍教会。
In her journal, you read when she was praying that the Lord was alleged to have said, "But that is how I treat my friends."
通过他自己写的那个日记上呢，你可以读到或者你可以看到呢，就是当他。祷告的时候神明明的回应了他，这就说神说这就是我怎样对待朋友的。
To which she quickly replied, Yes, my Lord, and that is why thou hast so few of them.
所以特蕾莎马上就回答神的给他的这个话，他就是的主啊，那就是为什么你有这么少的朋友。
And well, don't get the wrong idea. She's a woman of prayer.
所以不要大家不要想歪了，但是她是一个祷告 的姊妹。
In the early years of her life, Teresa suffered serious illnesses, including paralysis.
所以在她早年的生活当中呢，她身上 遭受 重大的疾病，她、也瘫痪了。
When she called the Christians with great urgency to have communion with God, she wrote.
她在她呼求这个基督徒们 要迫切的与神有一个交流，一个交通的时候呢，她写道。
Souls without prayer are like people whose body or limbs are paralyzed. They possessed feet and hands, but they cannot control them.
他写到，没有祈祷的人，如同身体和他的四肢瘫痪的人，他们是有手有脚，却不能运用。
She gave us an image regarding our lives and our prayers. It is a metaphor.
当然，他就给了我们一个活生生的一个画面，就关于我们的生命，我们的祷告。这是一个比喻啊。
In the metaphor, our lives are the garden, and our prayers are the water.
所以这个比喻是这样的，我们的生命呢，就像一个园子一样，然后我们的祷告呢，就是水。
There are four ways to water the garden.
所以有四种方法呢，来给这个园子浇水。
The first way is we take water out of the well with a bucket.
第一种方法呢，我们是用水桶从水井里面把水给打出来。
This one is very laborious.
当然这是很累的一种。
The second way is to raise water by means of a water wheel.
第二种方法呢，就是把水给提出来，是通过那种水车。
This one is easier. After you have tools, after you have learned someso-called prayer technique.
当然你 有一些工具过后，也就是说我们说的祷告的技巧过后呢，这种方法就显得更容易一点。
The third way to water your garden is by a stream or brook that passes through the garden.
第三种浇灌你园子的方法，就是引一条小溪或者小河呢，来穿过你的园子。
The fourth way is,by showers of rain from heaven.
当然第四种方法就是通过天上下下来的雨水。
Right now, at this time, what kind of level you are in there?
所以现在你在你的生命当中，你是处于哪一种方式，哪一种水平呢？
Your prayer and your life, which one?
你的生命和你的祷告，我们刚刚讲的这个比喻。
Brothers and sisters, what kind of life you are having right now? And what kind of prayer you are praying every day?
弟兄姐妹们，你们现在有什么样的一种生命呢？在你每天的祷告当中，你是怎样祷告的呢？
I don't know if you ever had a chance to think about your life, this time on earth thing.What's the meaning of it?
我不知道里面有多少人有时间有机会静下心来想一想你自己的生命，你说在这个地球上我们这个时间我们自己的生命。
If I am not a Christian, the purpose of my life is to die, not to live, because the wage of sin is death.
如果我不是一个基督徒的话，因为罪的工价就是死，所以我活在这个世上的目的呢，就是等死，而不是活着。
But if I am a Christian, the purpose of my life is to live forever, not die.
但是如果我是一位基督徒的话，那我生命的意义呢，就是活着，永远的活着，不是死。
Death becomes the gate that I enter into eternity because of the death of Jesus, my Lord.
因为我们的主耶稣基督的死 所以呢，这个死亡呢，也是我们进入永恒的那个门槛。
But now, how do I live through this time on earth thing, this life? I have to get the answer how through my prayer.
所以现在就是我们要问的问题，就是我们怎样在这个地上过这一生。所以我们要找到答案呢，只能通过我们的祷告。
I want to use a story to conclude my series of the Sermon of Prayer.
所以我想用一个故事呢，来结束我今天关于讲祷告的这一课。
The story is originally written by Elena Pascali.
所以这个故事呢，开始是被一位叫做 Elena Pascali 她所撰写的。
I have made some change of it.
但是我稍微改了一点点。
The title of the story is The Prayer of Three Trees.
所以这个故事我给取个名字就叫三棵树的故事。
Three Trees. Long ago, far away, on a hillside stood three trees.
在很久很久以前，在很远很远的地方，有一座小山丘，在山丘上面呢，长着了三棵树。
In the spring, their roots drank in the cool raindrops that trickle through the soil.
在春天来的时候呢，他们的树根呢，或者从泥土中剩下的凉爽的雨滴。
In the summer, they unfold their leaves to the sun.
在夏天呢，迎着太阳，他们的树展开它的叶子。
In the autumn, strong winds tussle their branches.
等秋天来的时候，强风拍打着他们的树枝。
In winter, they rested under the sparkling snow.
冬天的时候，他们在闪闪发亮的积雪的下面安眠。
Under the night sky that glittered with stars, they dream their dreams and pray their prayers.
他们这三棵树经常在繁星闪烁的夜空下面，一起梦想着自己的将来，一起为自己的梦想祷告。
Mine, says the first tree, is of riches.
第一棵树说，我的梦想就是财富。
I pray that God will make me into a beautiful chest that will hold the greatest treasure of the world had ever known.
我祈求上帝呢，使我在将来成为一个美丽的藏宝箱，让我里面可以装进呢这世界上最珍贵的宝贝。
Mine, said the second, is of power.
第二棵树说呢，我的梦想，我的向往是权力。
I pray that God will make me into a proud ship in which a mighty king will travel around his domain.
我愿上帝呢，使我将来可以变成一艘伟大的船，让伟大的国王、神作主可以周游他的领地。
The third tree sighed in the breeze. I don't want to go anywhere.
第三棵树在微风中轻轻地叹了口气说，我哪儿也不想去。
It says quietly, I pray God can let me stay here on the hillside, pointing to heaven where God lives.
我哪儿也不想去，我求上帝可以一直让我在这小山丘上静静地指向天堂，他住的地方。
Many years went by. The trees grew tall and strong.
许多年过去了，这三棵树呢，就长得又高又壮。
One day, three woodcutters climbed the hill, each with an axe in their hands.
有一天呢，有三个伐木工呢，就爬上了这座小山丘，他们的手里呢，就拿着斧头。
I am ready for riches, says the first tree as it fell.
当第一棵树喊着第一棵树倒下的时候，他口里喊着，他喊着宝藏啊，我来了。
I bow to the king, said the second.
第二棵树也很激动，他说我准备好了，我来服侍，我来跪拜在我的国王面前。
But the third tree shed his fragile leaves like tears. Now God rejects my prayers. It wept as it fell to the ground.
第三棵树呢，它脆弱的叶子呢，就像泪珠一样洒下。它一边哭一边倒在地上，心想：上帝拒绝了我的祷告。
A carpenter took the wood from the first tree.Saw it into planks and joined them.
一个木匠呢，就拿到了第一棵树，把它锯成了木板。
It was a box he made, and he made it well.
然后呢，他的拼接出来，做了一个很好的、很结实的一个箱子。
But it was not a chest.
那可是那不是一个藏宝箱。
It was a sturdy trough, a manger.
而是一个很结实的，可以喂牛、喂马的吃饭的一个马槽。
An innkeeper came and caught it away. Every evening he filled it with hay from the weary creatures that his guests brought to his stable.
一个客店的老板呢，就把它买了，每天晚上放在它里面呢，就来放饲料，喂养那些路过的客人呢。他们那些疲惫的牲口。
Such a humble life, sighed the tree. Such a poor and dismal place.
第一棵树叹息道：“主啊，怎么如此贫穷和卑微的生活啊？”
One night, the innkeeper led the animal aside, and a man and a pregnant woman took shelter in the stable.
有一天晚上，客店老板呢就把动物领到一边，一个男人和一个怀了孕的大肚子的女人呢就住了过来。
Later, a babe wrapped in cloths was laid in the manger.
所以过了一些时候呢，一个婴孩用这个布包住呢，就把它放在了马槽里面。
Under the bright shining star.When hearing the voice of an angel singing, the first tree suddenly realized that he is holding the greatest treasure the world had ever known.
在星光灿烂的照耀下，耳边就传来了天使歌唱的声音。第一棵树忽然意识到，它里面所放的正是这个世界上最珍贵的宝贝。
The shipbuilders took the wood from the second tree.
造船的人呢，就把第二棵树呢拿过来了。
They saw it and they shaped it and they smoothed it, sealed it. A fishing bowl was made.
他就把它这个树锯成木板，经过成型呢，打磨密封啊，就把它做成了一艘渔船。
Each evening, fishermen slided into the deep blue waters of the sea, sailed it off into the night, and cast their nets. Later, hauled them aboard full of slithering fish.
每天傍晚呢，渔夫们就会把这只船呢，架到深蓝的海水里面，整夜劳碌，撒网打鱼，打满了鱼。
Such a weary life, said the tree, and among such ordinary people.
第二棵树叹息道：“主啊，这么普通的人，这么普通的生活。”
One night, storm winds blew and great waves crashed.
有一天晚上，狂风大作，巨浪快要把船给撞碎了。
Then a man stood up in the boat and spoke to the storm, Peace, be still. And at once there was calm.
这是一个人站在船上，斥责风向海说，住了吧， 进了嘛，风就止住了，大大的平静了。
The second tree suddenly realized that he was carrying the mightiest king the world have ever known.
所以第二棵树呢，忽然意识到史上最伟大的国王正乘坐着他，周游他的领地。
The wood from the third tree was roughly hewn and left in a woodyard, almost forgotten.
第三棵树呢，被砍下来之后呢，就粗略的把刨了一下皮呢，就被扔在树木场里面，几乎呢被遗忘了。
One day came a glamour of voices. Any wood will do, but fetch it quickly.
有一天呢，忽然呢，他就响起了嘈杂的声音。他听见一个人喊：“什么木头都可以，要快。”
Rough hands grasped the wood and hastily make a cross. Cruel hands force a man onto it and nail him there by his hand and feet.
有一只粗糙的手呢，就把这个木头呢抓住了，很快呢就把它做成了一个十字架。又有残酷的手把一个人拉过来。把他的手和脚呢就钉在上面。
Soldiers hoist the cross upright there on a low barren hilltop. The man died.
然后士兵们就把十字架给直立起来，在一个小山坡上，最后被钉的十字架的那个人就死了。
And then he was buried.As the sun sank low, it felt despair deeper than it had ever known. Though the sun rose and set again, every hour felt like darkness.
最后这个死人被取下来埋葬了，日出日落，第三棵树只觉得黑暗和绝望越来越强烈。
Then came a bright dawn. By a miracle, the man who had died was seen alive again.
这一次第三天的早晨，神迹发生了，那个死去的人呢，复活了。
The tree that had borne his death was now a symbol of his life.
所以这个象征他死亡的这个十字架呢，成为他象征他永恒生命的标志。
The fir tree suddenly realized that he will stay here on the hillside, pointing to heaven, where God answered his prayer.
第三棵树忽然意识到，他将会在这小山丘上，静静地指向天堂，上帝应允他祷告的地方。
Let us pray.
我们祷告。
Lord, please teach us how to pray. Help us to pray and lead our prayers so our prayers can reach you.
主啊，祈求你教导我们怎样祷告，帮助我们祷告，引领我们祷告，所以我们的祷告可以达到你的面前。
Your ways are higher than our ways. Your thoughts are higher than our thoughts.
你的道路高过我们的道路，你的意念高过我们的意念。
When we pray, open the heaven for us. Reveal your glory. Give us your truth and grant us your peace.
当我们祷告的时候，祈求你打开天上的窗户，显明你的荣耀，展现你的真理，把你的平安赐给我们。
May each one of us love you and adore you.
愿我们在座的每一位爱你，并且尊崇你。
May each one of our sins be confessed and forgiven.
愿我们每一个罪在你面前得到赦免，在你面前得到认罪。
You are the one and only Lord.
你是那唯一的、唯一的主。
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
因为国度、权柄、荣耀全是你的，直到永远。Amen.